that way, I know it's key. This just gets submerged. Use that to transfer water from here into the hot liquor tun, into the mash tun. Does a lot of the calculations for you. You know, you tell it your equipment. Like you see, it says my equipment, and I told it what kind of things I use, brew kettle, mash tun, stuff like that. So it does a lot of the calculations. So I know that I want to get about 4.5 gallons of water in that pot over there and get it heating up. So this is like the central piece of brewing equipment. It's called a mash tun. Not everybody uses these. You use these if you use all grain. You want to do it the right way. What this does is, you see down there, that braid acts as a filter, and so you're going to fill this full of hot water and crushed grains for a specific amount of time, and the time varies depending upon the recipe, and the temperature varies widely depending upon the recipe. So then what you do is you let it kind of, the hot water just sit with the grains, and it washes complex sugars out of the grains. And then you're going to collect those complex sugars. The complex sugars are what turns into beer. The yeast eats the complex sugar and basically pees out alcohol.
So technically speaking.
It's a very beautiful process. We'll collect about 4.5 gallons in this. Is the temperature that you steep the grains at. Because low temperatures make a dry, high alcohol beer, where high temperatures make a real sweet, kind of thick, you know, full-bodied beer. And depending on the style you're brewing, you may want that or may not want that. So you have to hit a very specific temperature, and it's not that easy to do it. That's a lot of times, you know, you used to have to do a lot of calculations based on what kind of material your mash tun was made out of and all that other stuff. This program is nice, it does it for you, but you usually need to come in quite a bit hotter than what you actually want to steep the grains, or mash it's called, at. So I'm gonna take this water here, and I'm gonna bring it to about 160 degrees, maybe a couple degrees hotter, and then we're gonna pour it in there, and then we're gonna dough our grains in. You'll see that whole process here in a minute. Pearl pale malt, about 11 pounds of that. Okay. Take a pinch. Tastes like bread.
It's customary.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's pretty good. Seven. We want 100, so about 110, so we want 160. So we got a ways to go still. Grain husks actually make your filter bed. The flour is what you wash your sugar out of, but the husks you see in there, that's what's actually going to make your filter for your beer. That's almost.
Calcium carbonate, yes. Also known as Tums.
Yeah, I guess that's what gypsum is, isn't it? So I'm going to add this to the mash water. About 20 grams worth of. I don't know if I'm gonna get 20 grams. That's the whole. All best way to do this is to pour in a little bit at a time and stir. So I need you to hold the camera and stir.
Roger. Here we go.
Stir that up nice and.
Left-handed.
There's a lot of stuff you can do with it after you're done making beer with it, too. I've made dog biscuits with it before. All kinds of stuff. You make bread out of it. Good compost. Lid off this guy so we don't create a vacuum.
Let's see what we got in here.
See
wow.
Where we're at temperature wise in here. See how well we held our temperature. Looks like it's going to be pretty good. There we go. Oh, yeah. Nice. We're still at about 148 degrees or so. So in all that time, we lost about maybe 1.5 degrees in an hour. That's how well this thing insulates.
Pretty good.
So. Boris Vorlov. No, Vorlov. You'll crack this open nice and wide. See how cloudy that is?
Yeah.
That's all the grain still coming through the grain bed. So you let it go until it's nice and clear. Just pour this right back on top of it. Ooh, that smells really, really, really good. And see, you can already see it's clearing out.
Yep.
You see there's less chunks and stuff in there. Mm-hmm. I'll probably do this maybe one more time. And we'll start emptying it right into the boil kettle. And we'll just let it empty completely before we do the next step, which is called a sparge. Sparge is just a German word for rinse.
That's where never was heard a disparaging word. Is that?
I'm pretty sure, yeah. Alright. There we go. That's it, man. And I don't start the burner immediately because you don't want to, this is sugar in here, and you don't want to scorch it. So you want to wait and get, you know, a good volume of wort in there before you apply a lot of heat to it, or else you can scorch the sugar.
All right.
That's pre-beer. Tube. I want to fall on the ground. I don't want it to re-sanitize
it. Got
it. Stir water back in again. Give it a nice good stir. Make sure it's all mixed properly. If you don't watch it, it'll actually boil right over the pot. Because the proteins in there give it like a nucleation, you know, for the bubbles and stuff. So you have to see it. Once the bubbles start getting towards the top there, you just hit it with a little bit of water and it'll go right back down.
So a watch pot never boils because... Oh, jeez.
It makes some snaps too. You let it get all
the way. I just want to turn that down.
Woo. Almost. Come on, baby. Damn. They normally don't want to boil over that bad. Come on, get down there. All right, there we go. It's starting to break.
Condensed hop oil.
Mm-hmm.
And what's the purpose of this?
Bittering. It's pure bitter with no additional flavor. So, which is what you want in a double IPA. But I mean, you want hot flavor too, but you also want some intense bitterness, and that's exactly what this is.
It's just a very viscous oil. Yeah.
Oh, smell that. That smells good.
Careful.
There you go.
Okay, the coils are in. The cooling coils.
Gotta crank this back up so we boil.
And so you're gonna be boiling the coils to sterilize them, right?
Sterilize them, right.
And then eventually running cold water through them
to cool everything, right.
Cool everything down to around 65.
Man, pretty good.